I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me.
I had this thing that being a new member of the Merchant Seamen, I wanted a tattoo to look, to my way of thinking then, butch and masculine. So I underwent the first tattoo, basically, to make myself look a man and not a little boy as I appeared to be in them days.
I tried so not to give in.
People are still a bit surprised at a woman being tattooed. It's almost like a sort of war paint idea in people's mind. It's a macho thing. They just can't quite come to terms with it on a woman.
I've got you under my skin.
If anybody can make a picture with a bit of chalk on a slate, that's art. It's like if a woman strips off, man, that's artistic. It's the same sort of thing, isn't it? It's just that we're using machines and she ain't.
And repeats in my ear, don't you know, little fool, you never can win. You your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin, 'cause I've got you under my skin. I've got you under my skin.
It's very inhibiting coming here for the first time. I don't think that's anything related to my sex. I think it's the fact that you're terribly nervous about having a tattoo done and you don't quite know what's involved. I found Myrian here very helpful and in no way pressurising me to have anything done, and very helpful about having my own designs done.
Whether to colour it later on, but I think we'll get it tattooed in first and then decide about colouring.
Decide after?
Yeah.
Right.
So, do you want to try it on my back?
Yeah,
and then we can
turn it
check,
on first,
check for size, yeah.
Oh, definitely the small one.
It was all done in privacy and it was done in a very relaxed, nice way.
Yeah.
Yes, that would be too large, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I regard Myron as a friend now. You sort of build up a relationship because you have to come so often to have a piece of work finished. It still takes a bit of courage to come up and have it done. It's still a bit of a struggle. Once I get you and get started, it's all right. It's very gratifying when total strangers say to you, oh, that's very nice, I like it. And again, I think a lot depends on what particular sort of subculture you move in. In fact, people tend to assume that I've got a motorbike because I've got tattoos. It's nice to break down people's preconceptions anyway.
So how much have you got left to do now? Just fill in the wings, is it?
Finished filling wings, next sitting now, yeah.
Great.
First sitting's finished. Basic outline on.
That was cold.
It looks nice.
Lovely. Wish I could see it.
I'll take my word for it.
Yeah.
I started tattooing about 12 years ago. David, my partner, he started me off. The first time I tattooed, it was very difficult. It was, you always had that feeling inside, you didn't want to hurt the person. But yet there was a feeling of enjoyment as well, because it was something that I wanted to do for a long time. And the first time I started, just done a little bit of shading and colouring. And the boy wasn't too happy about it. I think I pressed a bit too deep anyway. And I done a full tattoo the next time I tattooed. That was a full tattoo, which was an eagle. I never forget it. It was about that big. It should have been that big, but it was about that big. And I still see that tattoo till today, but and it's still all right.
I don't black you.
No. Well, I worked in a colliery first. There was no satisfaction as such. Only the mates who had in work. So I was fascinated by tattoos. and drawing of all sorts of birds, anything, you know. I decided to go professional, mainly to help out people that was in my situation who had put a tattoo on as they were in school and regretted it. I could put right. The traditional designs, three feathers or mum and dad, and they are still my favourite.
Right, shall we start now? This wall here, full of designs. Start off with eagles there, various sizes, various colours, some with snakes around, some with skulls. Move along to the women, don't seem to be doing many of them now, except the geisha girls there. Move along to cats then, quite popular, sheet of tigers there, very popular. Then we got loads of sheets then of scrolls with hearts and roses, knives, birds, flowers. These are the type that people have girlfriends' names, mum and dad, girls and boyfriends' names, sons, daughters. And we got the Welsh tattoos then. These are the most popular. Soldiers get them. A lot of people who just want one tattoo get this type as well. Move along then to these very small designs here. Won't cost more than £10, but these are the type that women usually have on their shoulder or in a very intricate place.
Okay, Francis, I've just finished cleaning the area now where you'd be tattooed. Just putting the transfer on now. What you'll find is the first few seconds will hurt. Francis? Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm just starting out right now, Francis. How was that, all right?
Yeah.
You start to get better now. The first tattoo, it's a big decision in life, major decision. And sometimes I always advise them to pick the right design because they're so permanent. And there is a regret rate in tattoo in some people, but most people who get tattoo really love their tattoos. That wasn't so bad, was it?
No.
Now the colouring won't hurt half as much. I think one tattoo on a woman is very appealing. But to have any more, the woman want to really think, and if she can have one, to have it in a place that she can hide it. And also to think it over more, rather than a man. Just finished, Frances. Can you see it?
Yeah, yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah. I had a big Japanese calendar at home with peacocks and flowers on. So I asked the boys, is there any chance of you doing this? And they said, yes, no problem. But it took 3 months altogether to do that. I work a lot with elderly people, and a lot of the ladies, they're fascinated by my tattoos. In fact, there's one elderly lady, she made me strip off in her front room so she could see the work I'd had done. Another thing they always ask me is, what are they going to look like when you're old yourself and your skin is all wrinkled? So I tell them I'll have plastic surgery to stretch it. My husband Paul has got a lot of Japanese work, full sleeve jobs as they call them. I'd like him to carry on eventually, probably have a full body job, but that's up to him if he wants to carry on and do it. I find tattooed men very attractive. In fact, when I'm sort of on the beach or something in the summer and I see all these men lying on the beach with just their bathers on, I find it odd, you know, not seeing any tattoos at all, just sort of plain.